We are here. It's Home Invasions. I like to call it for this year, but it's time because it's October, which means Junior Quail is coming up. I know it's a new normal with that, but guess what? We are here to bring back what we know, what we're familiar with. And this edition of our Creative Creole Cooking is called Majela Kai. So I don't think this lady needs any introduction.
I want one.
I think she deserves an introduction. I mean, with so many accolades, I think
not to mention we've not introduced ourselves. We can't just assume that St. Lucia knows all our faces, right? So where we started, people?
Without further ado, the woman of the hour, or chef, Glamour Art by Toya.
All right, more than just makeup today, guys. All right, so she have another hidden talent you don't know about. This is why this episode is going to be super exciting. So yes, you're going to find out. I suspect everybody now, all the clients, Toya,
I have to cook for them.
Yeah.
Every time they come for a face meet. Oh,
yes.
Boy.
All right, don't have Toya special. Whatever you cook today could be like the special of the month of October. So
definitely,
you can get your face beats and you snap
them. Oh, wow. Wow. Wow.
You see how good ideas come about?
You give me work, boy. You give me a lot of work.
If we do good, you know, you can probably hire us to help you prep and stuff.
No problem. Not because
I'll just be the taster. You know, that's right up just to make sure everything is good.
Well, at this rate, I don't think your clients might get much then. After that, we'll have to check. But St. Lucia, thank you so much, and welcome to not our kitchen, but to Toya's kitchen today.
Welcome.
All right.
So, what are we gonna be doing?
Well, we're making conch fritters.
All right.
And we have a little tamarind sauce to, you know, dip in and eat with at the end with the conch fritters.
This sounds all good. Right. This sounds good.
Yes.
And you know what I realized? Yeah, we're in October. It's the nutrition month. That's the month where everybody's healthy, because October is Je Ne Quoi All and December is Christmas. So food. So we're in that section of the year.
True.
So listen, Corona not stopping that.
No.
At all.
Je Ne Quoi All will move on. This is where the year starts to get brighter and happier
and healthy.
Better.
It's true.
And healthy. Just put that there. All right. So I'm ready to go. So Toya, let's talk about your ingredients. What we have here.
Okay, so we have, well, the main ingredient, which is conch. I had to beat it and chop it up. You have to beat the conch, because if you don't beat it, it's going to be tough.
Okay.
So it comes whole. This is what it comes looking like. It comes whole like this. And then you see how hard it is, because it's a muscle. Sure. So it comes whole like this. That's what it looks like.
Oh, okay.
So what you eat.
This don't is think you've ever seen it in that.
Really?
I've never seen it.
Right. So it comes like this, and you have to beat it out and then chop it up. If you want to use it in like the fritter, you have to beat it and chop it.
Okay, cool.
If not, if you want to grill it, you still have to beat it down. And it takes a while, because it's a muscle, you have to beat it, or it's going to be tough.
What's,
I don't know if
muscle?
You've ever had tough lobby.
I have.
Like,
you're just
it's,
chewing
endlessly. It's, yeah, and your mouth starting to get numb, and you're like, oh my god, is this exactly?
Actually, no. This is the point where I confess. So, guys,
you do not
never eat. No, I don't eat. Well,
what?
I say, you know me, I'm not that exotic, but this is the time of year you'll get me to try something.
You've
new.
Never
so
had lobby?
So many people around me love it, and I always opt out.
I don't want to believe you've never had lobby.
And that's
Sheila
it.
Has not.
No, this is.
Last year, if you'll follow, I do not eat exotic. I'm very simple. Now,
a
all these things are very exotic.
But yeah, it's too simple for me. I love lobby.
In the spirit of Je Ne Quoi All, you know, you always have me trying something new. So
speaking of something new, last year we had Maniku.
Yeah.
Oh, really? I've never had it. I've never had turtle. Never had Maniku. I don't think I'll eat Maniku, because you see, when I see something running across the road looking like a rat, it's not about that.
It's an acquired taste.
No.
It is definitely an acquired taste. I'm grateful for the experience, but never again.
You know, again, it's a season for all the wild meat.
Wild, yes, very wild.
Unusual things that we don't normally get.
Well, Sheila, this is right up your alley. You've never had.
So you've never had it, so you're
gonna
have it. It's
today.
It's we're doing something like an acro.
Okay.
Right. So we have main ingredient conch. We have our seasoning. This is actually from my garden.
Oh.
So we have some thyme. We have some chives. Well, spring onions. We have some big leaf thyme. That's what we call it.
Okay.
And we have some parsley. Then we have some seasoning peppers. Red onions, seasoning peppers, red onion, some garlic. You need garlic when you're cooking. I feel like garlic is an essential ingredient. Like,
right.
It just makes the food.
Remember, we liked that last last year that salt and pepper, those aren't
seasoned. No, honey.
Not in the Caribbean.
If you see you go to somebody's house and all they use to season is salt and black pepper, run. The food will not have no taste. It will not be good.
Now, you know, that's one of the things I love about our St. Lucian culture and our heritage, because, I mean, when we look at our Creole culture too, the food is a big part of it.
It is.
When you think of the technology they had back then to cook and do these kind of things, like just a coal pot and not the stoves and pans that we have, but they were able to prepare dishes that taste so good.
It's true.
With
simple ingredients.
Simple utensils and, you know, items to help them cook, but a lot of mercy.
And you know what makes it even more special? The colors of the ingredients
matches
the outfit.
And then we have white onion. Then we have dry ingredients. This I love to cook with. It's a complete seasoning, so it has garlic powder, salt, black pepper, thyme, oregano, basil. It's like a
full
dried parsley, granulated garlic. We have some dried thyme, some black pepper, flour, and baking powder. And salt. How could I forget salt?
Yes.
Baking powder, salt, and that's it. That's all you need to create this dish.
All right. So what about your ingredients for your little sauce?
My little sauce. Well, I did the sauce earlier because it took some time, but it's basically tamarind, honey, sugar, garlic, and that's it. And you put it to boil, and then you strain it, and then you have your tamarind sauce.
Okay, cool.
Simple, yeah. But you have to put it to boil for a while.
Which color? Like half an hour,
20 minutes?
Like an hour
and a half.
That's a lot. Yes, it takes some time. Because you want the tamarind flavor to get infused with everything, and then you want a nice thick sauce.
Okay.
You don't want a thing, you know, runny. And,
I like my stuff rich,
and then you want it
so
flavorful. Right. I mean, that's a part of cooking. You like flavor.
I agree.
Yes, so let's get started. So I'm just going to chop up some white. I'm going to chop up basically everything here. I already chopped up the lobby, the conch. It's a lot, but you know, you want to when you buy. I don't like eating akra and you're not tasting the sausage.
Like,
and less flour and onions. It don't have you're not tasting. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to make sure I had enough conch. So when you bite into it, the first thing you taste is the lobby, the conch. So I'm just gonna chop up the onions.
Let me wash my hands.
All right, it should be your show.
Well, no, I just know Shannon's skills way better than mine.
I beg your pardon? Excuse me?
I'm going to show, and you're going to chop, and then we're going to mix everything and then fry. So, let's get started. So, let's switch places.
Let's see if I remember how to.
All right, high five. I know you can do this. Let's show our skills.
So we're going to chop the onion.
Let's warm up. Okay.
You want to stretch? You want to stretch your legs, Michael? Okay.
There's a method to it, you know.
There's a method, okay.
Okay, be careful.
The precision.
Okay.
Look at that.
Right. Be careful. I see you have the long nails, though, cut
it there. I was about to say, not one nail.
We're not eating nails today. We're eating fritters, corn fritters, okay?
Yeah. Okay.
Girl, I'm excited about this, sir. I love acras. I always wanted to know how to make it good.
Love acras. I was going to do acras, and then I was like, let me make it a little interesting. Oh, be careful.
I think I finished it.
You finished?
Yeah.
Okay, my God. You still have another one to do.
I hope you all didn't see that.
Wash your hands and less.
Cleanliness first.
Cleanliness.
Leave that for you. But I mean, it's Chef Shanro RD. Boyardee, Chef
Shanro. We'll go with that.
There we go.
I had to put a little Creole something on my head because I felt like, ooh.
You're in your way, Shannon, a little Madras something.
You see, I can explain.
Okay.
It's your Madras.
Okay.
What
happened was. Okay.
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 All pieces.
All right. Watch my little sous chefs.
Yes.
Doing such a good job.
Don't worry. October special, I remember that, people.
Okay.
That is good.
So we
dice it. Yes, we want to dice it really fine because we don't want to bite into the fritter and then you get a big chunk of that will not be very good.
Alright, we're almost there.
Okay.
Now, if you're not hearing that sound, you're not doing it right.
Yeah,
you'll give me so much ratings.
Yeah, big ratings, in my girl.
Ooh, I feel so bad there right now.
Big ratings.
Look at that.
Okay, Emerald.
Wow.
Our chefs from last year would be proud.
Yes, I'm seeing.
For sure.
All right.
Okay. Awesome. So we just want to chop it up a little finer.
Okay.
So we're gonna go
Okay, well, you see, she didn't put me in the shape.
No, but we want it to be just as fine as possible.
Agreed.
So you don't taste the onion. When you see you bite into it, you don't get a big piece of onion mm-hmm. in the... And I have nails, so I have to get a creative way of chopping vegetables okay. without chopping my nail and you
Let
bite
me
it
into
it.
Messier, there's an ingenious, simple piece of equipment for your kitchen. It's a mini chopper mm-hmm. and it's a lifesaver.
I just
now,
bought
somebody
one.
Once told me, they saw me on a video call using it, right? Because you just pull the top and you could throw your garlic, your onions, everything, and everything.
Mm-hmm. Everything
nice
just chopped up. Mm-hmm.
They're like, yeah, weed eater you have in your house, man, because I was good. But it really saves the time.
I just ordered one.
Okay.
Well, so we're going to mix everything in that bowl. So I'm just going to take the onion and just place it in the bowl. Everything.
One thing you can tell Toya like to cook, eh? Because you notice not one onion is dropping off this knife from here to there. Like, okay. So I know when I'm not seeing her in my life, I know what she's doing.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm not live tonight, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Now, okay. Funny story with how I knew Toya was, you know, chef in the kitchen. I was minding everybody else's business, as per usual, but my own. And I saw Toya in the kitchen cooking coconut shrimp and curry. And I'm like... Mm-hmm. Okay, so
undercover chef, you know.
Undercover, I tell you. I have special decor on the plates. I'm like, okay, I have plans for you.
And my first experience was a party right here, and everybody was hungry by the end of the evening. And Toya most graciously had pasta salad. May say, ask Toya, ask clients to for
Toya
her pasta
remembers.
Salad.
Really?
But I think she probably knows that people give her ratings for that too. And everybody was just like, oh my god, this is good in tutus, everything cleared out. And that's when I was like, oh, can I say this on camera?
No, I don't think Toya
cooks very good. There's a sound effect on that, but you'll know what.
So now we're going to chop up our chives. This is from my garden outside. I started a little garden like 2 years ago. So I have basil outside, thyme, parsley, celery, big leaf thyme, rosemary, chives. I just started green peppers.
Wow.
And I wanted to do, so I'm just starting cucumber.
Okay.
So,
aren't you happy that you did that 2 years ago? Look at what's happening.
I am because I cook so often. I needed to at least have something outside. So when
yeah.
I wanted to make something,
you
I just go outside. Boom, bam, outside.
The definition of eat what you grow.
Yeah. My neighbor actually, she has watermelon, cantaloupe, kale, lettuce, limes. She has like a full garden, sweet potato. She has everything.
So may say if you're missing things in your house, you'll know where to go and get them. The market don't have.
And seriously,
home
saying that, and funny enough, this is what we're here to do, cook Creole cooking, but even when we think of long ago, most people were growing their little
things.
All of these
yeah.
things were just in your backyard. They knew which bush for what meat
it's
and
true.
What bush for what illness. And, you know, so I just listened to you saying that and all what you have right now. And I feel like, you know.
And I think with them growing it in their backyards, it was a lot of trial and error to figure out what goes where and, you know, how what helps with what. So that's also another essential to growing.
It's important. Trust me. It helps. Trust me. I don't have to rush in the supermarket if I'm missing something. I just go in the backyard and pick it.
Now you see, that's what I tell you. Respect the old people, you know, because all of us are relatively young.
Yes.
So, you know, our knowledge of Creole is passed down from our elders. But, you know, when you look at that, again, we stop to think about, as you said, you know, they knew how to mix and match. They figured it out. They did so much for us. And, you know, right now, even
they were the ones who paved the way.
It's fact.
Just saying. But, you know, it's just shows.
We run for that.
I don't know what you're talking about. We just said they paved the way.
They did. They did indeed. So we're going to chop this up. So my little chef. So you want to put all together. Make sure all together. And you just want to go like this.
Okay,
Shana, you want to come?
Okay.
It's easy, but you want it to be really, really small, eh? So come.
Okay. I feel like you have this. I mean, like, you have the
stand. You're already standing there.
Rock, paper, scissors. Okay, so you do it.
No, you lost. What? Seriously? Dang. Okay. All right. Here we
really
go.
Small. Yes.
You see?
Don't worry, Michael. You'll be good to put in house when you finish
confidence.
It. Good to put in house.
I know 2021 now. Everybody looking to get married next year.
Who?
Your plans is?
You have plans?
Not me, no.
Toya, you have plans?
You all have something, man.
No, but everybody's saying 2020, they're ready to say goodbye.
And you all know something?
This year will happen next year.
You all know something?
I don't know anything. I'm just minding my business. You're chopping chives.
Oh, okay.
So Toya, what sparked your interest in the kitchen?
When I was younger, my mom used to work really long hours, and I had to learn how to cook at home, being home by myself.
Yes.
At the time, okay. I was. I have a sister, she's 13 now.
Okay.
But I used to have to learn how to make things on my own. Mm-hmm. So I learned how to make bakes at 9, cook at 9, do cocoa tea, and all these things that I love these dishes.
Wow.
And
my career,
let me tell you. So I learned how to do certain things on my own, and then my grandmother taught me a few things. My aunt can cook really well. My mom is a really good cook. So me picking up on that, and then I just love to put dishes together.
Mm-hmm. So are we seeing a Glamour Food by Toya coming soon?
We
can have
a can you chop? Can you chop? Okay.
Don't speak into me. Okay.
I mean, just chop. Thinking, just you're doing a good job. You're doing a good job.
Just thinking.
Next time I want to come up with some creative ideas.
I love that for you. You know
We don't need to do the small one. We have enough.
Okay. Right.
So we're just gonna take all the chives.
And
place in the bowl.
Everything on the knife one time, right?
And nothing at full still.
Just habits,
okay.
Right? So now we're going to chop the thyme. This is also from my garden. We washed it. Just gonna take it.
Shara, I never see chopped thyme before.
Don't even try.
This is also thyme. This is a bigger, there's a smaller one as well.
Yes, not. I want to call it goody-tay.
Goody-tay.
Yes, that's a big thyme and a little thyme.
So you just want to chop this?
Yes.
Yeah, big time. It's true. That's what they say.
Godite.
I'm learning as we go along, because back home, we don't have big time and little time. We just have one time.
And so just going to chop
time.
This up.
Nice. And that smells so good.
It's so fragrant. Mm-hmm. Like, I love it. I cook with it a lot. And it comes in honestly, it just grows up. So you just have to take off some stems off the sides and...
How do you even grow that? Do you just take like a leaf and, you know?
Well, you get a small plant and then it grows. I get my plants from my neighbor by the Montessori school.
Mm-hmm.
He gives me all my plants. He has chamomile tea.
Oh, nice.
He has every single plant you could think of.
Okay.
Red basil. You ever see a red basil plant? It's red.
No.
It's beautiful.
Nice.
He has everything in his garden selling.
Shout out to the Montessori neighbor.
So we're just going to chop this up. Right?
Mm-hmm.
It's a lot of chopping, it's a lot of seasoning to get this to have as much flavor as possible.
But it has to be colorful, just like
it has
culture,
to be
so
colorful. It has to be tasty and it has to be flavorful. Just chop this up. For this one, you don't need a lot because as you can smell it, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's
it's
so fragrant. Godite.
Mm-hmm.
You're just gonna add that to your bowl. And then we're gonna do our peppers. So we have red, yellow, green peppers. These are seasoning.
I mean, those are your favorite colors. Go, girl.
Really? So we're gonna chop this. So simple way to chop it, you go here, and then you put it together, and then you go across. Just like so. I know I'm doing it fast, but
I'm carefully observing. You see, we're aspiring to catch up, so Ooh, and I see a hot pepper there.
Yeah.
The spicy sound.
Okay, so let's go.
Right up your alley.
Right up your alley.
Let's go.
Okay. You do a good job. You do a good job.
Now you wanna
cut it from the inside because the outside, the skin is a little bit more tough.
Okay.
So it's easier to
sense.
Right.
Alright.
I learned something today.
3 hours later, I'll still be here. Okay.
Don't cut your finger.
Don't try that. Saint Lucia, you seen that? I didn't look like I was going to cut my hair, right? You all know that. That's old games. The camera doesn't lie, you know. We don't know about the cameraman, but
what's
the camera
your favorite,
doesn't.
Jaden? Creole dish growing up.
I have a lot, but I love cocoa tea. I'm a cocoa tea
Me
freak.
Me too, oh my gosh.
I could drink 3-4 cups of cocoa tea in one sitting.
Listen, I drink in it hot, I drink in it cold.
Well, I'm not.
I
don't know about the cold.
When I make mine, it's very rich, very strong.
Mine is very
dark chocolate. It has to be nice and thick.
Yeah.
And when I sweeten it, I have a little bit of a sweet tooth. That's okay.
Mm-hmm, that's perfect.
Okay, super. So I have a little bit of a sweet tooth, so it has been sweetened to perfection and thick and rich and nice.
Do you use flour or custard too?
Custard.
Okay, good. Good.
You see
custard.
That's That's right.
Tea flower is a no no.
Flower is only if when I happen to open my cupboard and
you have no custard. But flower is a no no. I feel like it has like a. It gives like a, the flavor and the taste is not that great.
It doesn't work for me.
It doesn't.
It's really not the same. But
it
yeah.
doesn't. Mm-hmm.
All right. Okay. 4 hours later, almost done.
So apart from cocoa tea, what else, Claire?
Cocoa tea, I like acras, clearly. I like saltfish. I like smoked herring. I love mackerel. I love stewed mackerel with peppers and onions. You haven't had it prepared properly. That's why your face is sour.
Let me tell you, that thing's smelling too fresh. That was too.
You have to put a lot of lime in it. A lot of
lime.
I
don't like fish with a lot of little bones, so.
But you like smoked herring?
No.
Oh, girl. Wait, you're not Lucian, man.
The only thing I'll say that, man, that's authentic. But no, I just. You know, it's alright.
So I like smoked herring, mackerel, saltfish. What else do I like? Well, smoke herring is house off.
I learned that word, so I'm exercising my vocabulary.
She learned something new.
What did I say? What? You kept forgetting the name last year. Shucks, it must come back to
yes,
me.
That was...
It was something that really made me catch my kicks.
AC,
you cannot even remember.
But it was good. That's
was it
I
mean. Was it one of those
a seasoning or something, you
it
know?
It was a seasoning.
It was?
Yes.
Yeah, it was a seasoning.
Bodita, we just say that.
No,
okay.
Wasn't that one?
I think the anise, you know.
Yes, that's the one.
I have them there.
That's the one.
Good. I put them in cocoa tea. Love it. It's very flavorful.
Okay. That's too big?
A little bit, but we're fine. We're fine.
Oh, let me tell you.
I'm
you
listen,
have to
you,
do the toy chop now where you.
You have to.
And when I toy chop my finger, like, what you have to say?
No, you have to like. Talk to me nice.
Well, okay, good girl.
Talk to me.
Not me. I wasn't on that level yet.
So you'll do the last two. You'll do the last
mind
two.
Mind you, she did all of that and it's the bocce chopping.
No, that's not true. That's not true.
I never can catch that.
Well, you'll do the last two and you'll be good. You'll do the last two.
I'm just going to set up myself there.
Boy, you even know what was coming. So what are your favorite Creole dishes?
Well, obviously, besides the cocoa tea, green fig and saltfish
for
me. Yes. For sure, with some pear, some breadfruit. I love my breadfruit, not sweet. I don't really like sweet stuff.
You know, Toya, we should have made you cook breadfruit, you know, because I saw a particular celebrity cutting the whole breadfruit with a
razor. Oh, Lord.
She just disrespected the breadfruit. I was very sad.
I think we should pause for a little cause right now, if in case you don't know what we're talking
Can
about.
Give her a moment of silence.
Right now.
Eaten most of my fruit from Tropical Fruit Box USA. Now I'm gonna try this. I've never tried it before. It's called a sweetbread. Looks like. I don't know. It's probably slime from Violet. I don't know, but your brother has some sweat. Something in his hair. Ta-da! What does this taste like? Let's find out. Okay, so I called it the wrong thing. It's not sweet bread. It's called breadfruit. Breadfruit. And I just took a little bite, and it tastes like a giant. It just tastes tropical. It's good. You want some?
I want to say guava, but I want to say another.
Okay, so now you know what we're talking about. I watched this lady buy this and said, oh, she gets her tropical fruit.
No, no, when
fruit
she
from
cut it first, she's like, I got this tropical fruit. What's it called again? A fruit bread or something like
that?
No,
a sweet bread, she called
bread.
It.
Sweet bread. And then she cuts it in half.
The disrespect.
Right, the people just saw it, so they know.
Then they're sitting and she's biting
it. I couldn't believe she bit it and smiled and said, okay, it's good, tasty. And I'm like, I know you're lying. That could never taste good.
It's raw. It's raw.
And
it has this milk that comes from it when you cut it.
I'm like, that glue must have been all in her mouth.
Boy, and she didn't
I'm sorry for her insides.
Boy.
What these nails impeded me so much there.
With a toya chop.
Just now, I'm
with a toya chop. Now
I'm struggling to do the regular chop. You talking about toya chop?
Okay, you see.
Well, these nails not working for me at all.
Well, even if they didn't catch it, is now
right. Life hack. There we go. There we go. I still have to cut that again, Toya.
Yes.
All right. Here we go. I do the toya chop now.
I get a whole chop nail. Why the toya chop?
Talk to me nice. What did I say?
This is funny.
Okay.
Good job. Good job. One more. We only have one more. And then we're going to do.
You ready? Go.
All right, one more.
Sorry.
Home cooked meal. Now, you know, one thing people don't really talk about Creole time, for me, I'm big on the desserts. Like, you see comfort, you
let
see
me tell
like
you, Pemi, sweet. Yes. Pemi is like my all-time. I made it actually 2 weeks ago. I was just feeling for it, and I thought still
randomly,
and I'm like, I tell him, I want to eat Pemi right now. He's like, well, go and see if you have anything in the fridge to do it.
I didn't know cornmeal was so bad.
Let me tell you, I love it. I love it. I love it.
I love that. And that was what used to be my
good stuff.
Diced to perfection.
I don't know that comfort. So it's like a Creole candy. And that's my favorite one because it's all minty and nice.
Yeah, I don't know.
It's really nice.
So then
I'm always eating something and I don't know what I'm eating. So probably I have had it. Probably.
I just put it in here.
It's one of my favorites. It's like a mint candy. How they make it, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know how they make comfort.
That's a good question.
That's a really good question. I don't know. Okay, so we have to do the parsley.
So do you do the same thing like you did with the...
Yeah. So you take off, I like to take off the stems because I don't really like the stems in my parsley. And then you want to go in.
And come over so it creates a little space.
Oh, yes.
And just chop it up.
Wait, so after we take 5 hours to cut the little wooden things again. And now check Toya just breezing through the parsley.
Because the thing is, I use a lot of fresh herbs in my cooking, like naturally. Yes. I don't only use, some people only use dry seasoning. Mm-hmm. I don't use chicken cube in my food at all. Mm-hmm. I don't use things like, you see those powdered seasonings that have a lot of, that have MSG. I don't use that.
Okay.
Fresh all the way from tarragon right down to chives and all of these things. Because I feel like it adds...
And it's a healthier way too.
Yeah, and it adds so much more flavor to your food. Imagine if you use fresh seasonings to cook with so much more flavor.
That's true. That's why I'm happy you're saying that. I hope, St. Lucia, you're hearing this. Because this is the whole point of that, you know. It's our Creole heritage.
Not, you see that? Let me tell you.
Yeah, it just has a difference. Like for me, because like I use garlic powder sometimes, but it's nothing like when I fresh chop my garlic as well.
Fresh garlic.
I think what I appreciate the most with the seasonings, each have their different scents. Different aromas, and I appreciate that a lot. So you can know when you're cutting your chives, you can know when you're cutting your thyme, you can know when you're cutting your onions. They just have a specific smell, and I appreciate that.
Now, around this time too, it always reminds me of cooking with my granny.
Yeah, I know he's good on him, so I don't
Never ventured
up. Toya's embarrassing me, he brought my friends.
It's just an easier way to chop it and get it fine before you go back in and chop it up. I'm sure everybody has their, you know, their technique that works for them, but this works for me, and that's what I do because, I mean, I have nails. I love my nails. I need to
So yeah, that's a Toya chop. So you have to ensure the fingers are up and then you
flat. I have a name, the Toya chop.
The Toya chop. There we go.
Okay. So onions are chopped nicely, and I love a red onion.
Yes, me too.
For the color
salad, because it's sweet.
It has a different taste to the white one.
It does. I put it in salads. I love it. Yeah. I eat it all the time in a nice vinaigrette.
I always tell people that garlic and onion are my two favorite things.
Okay, so now
look at tuna too.
Look at how pretty that is.
Yes.
This looks really, really nice.
I think they're generous.
And it's just seasoning that's in there.
Yeah.
Only.
And the so smell. Far.
And the smell is so
you
good.
See? So Messier, we have to go back to planting our own. Okay?
No powder, nothing.
So grow your own. That's what the people used to do long ago. We have to get back into that.
So we're gonna do garlic. I'm gonna use a garlic press now. Don't judge my garlic press, eh? It's been through some war.
It's Creole season. Like it passed down from generations. There's a story behind it, and we stick into that, so remember that people, okay?
So you just want to press it down. I love this garlic press because I don't have to do no chopping.
Mm-hmm.
So I used 4 cloves of garlic.
Okay.
And you want to take out. Okay. So now we're going to add our flour. And then we're going to add our powdered seasoning, baking powder, and then the conch, and then some water.
Just in case you guys want to know what inside looks like.
It's about time we get Smell-O-Vision. That's all right. I'm saying. Wish you were here.
This really smells good.
It smells good, right?
Cheese.
Okay, so to that, we're going to add, I'm going to make you all add the dry seasoning. So we're going to measure all the dry seasonings to add it. So we're going to use 1 teaspoon of everything.
Okay.
So you could put 1 teaspoon of garlic powder, 1 teaspoon of this. You could start with that.
Okay, a little bit of this.
1 teaspoon of that. Right, perfect, nice.
You see, you have the sprinkle.
She has the sprinkle. She good. She has the sprinkle. So 1 teaspoon of dried parsley.
There we go.
Okay.
See,
you see it work. Very nice. You see, she has the sorbet.
I
know
that one, but that's my vision.
So we're gonna use 1 teaspoon of garlic powder.
Let's go. Okay, we need a little more team. Okay. Is it okay if I put it chunky?
No, you want to get the fine part.
Just kind of press it out with the spoon.
Okay, so let's see.
That makes sense.
Okay. Right?
All right.
We're gonna take 1 teaspoon of oregano. Can it fit? Can this fit? No.
No, so we're gonna
do the same.
Teamwork.
Okay. And we're gonna do 1 teaspoon of salt. Cause you wanted to make, and this is sea salt, eh?
Okay.
I don't use regular salt. Sea salt is the best. It has the most flavor, I feel like. And we're just not going to use a teaspoon, but we're just going to do a little sprinkle
of black pepper.
Okay. Simple. So you want to mix this, Shannon. It's for you to mix. Sure. Mix it around. So she's going to mix it all around.
Okay. Only mix a row.
Just how you're cooking for us, eh?
Well, she promised it last year.
We don't know about that. She's not keeping her promises.
Call me Mixer Roo. I got you. I promise. Next year. Exactly.
Nice. Very nice. This smells so good.
Now, you know what it's reminding me of? Last year when we made the Souskai.
Because
it had like all
the... That's how you make Souskai. That's how you make it.
Okay.
So you want to add the kong to that. And then we're going to add the pepper, the baking powder.
Go ahead and just use this?
Yes. Okay. So you see how it's chopped up? It's almost like it's in a paste, but it's not really. So break it up and just mix everything.
I'm just gonna break it up, and then here we go.
I need a...
This looks so good. Can we eat this raw?
You can. You could probably do like a ceviche and add some lime juice, and you could eat it like that.
Because I know in the Bahamas too, they do it both cooked and raw too.
Yeah, so you could do a nice little ceviche.
Okay, this looks good, y'all. That looks good.
Yeah, that's admitted.
That looks good.
Yeah. Ooh, you're making me hungry. Okay, to that.
I think it's the other way around.
I can't
believe
you're going to make it happy today. Yeah?
To that, we're going to add 1 cup of flour.
So all this time, Akko is this easy?
You didn't know that?
No.
I was intimidated. Ah, so there's your liquor, I'm not missing out.
So you can make your own stuff at home.
Definitely.
Hence the name?
Magie la carte.
Right.
We go work on the dance and we'll have a dance and a little theme song. Yeah.
Okay, so that we want to add baking powder. You want to take 1 teaspoon of baking powder and add it there and mix.
1 teaspoon thingy.
We're coming to come.
Hey! Looking
nice. Okay.
Yes.
Solve
it.
Okay,
pal. You see?
Okay.
We're good kitchen assistants.
So now we're going to add some water.
So the baking powder is to actually give you that rise?
Yes, that little rise that you get. So we're going to add some water.
What amount of water?
Maybe a couple. See, but you don't want the consistency to be watery.
Okay.
You want it to be thick enough so when you scoop it to fry it,
you're
right.
Okay.
So you just want to add a little bit at a time.
Okay.
So we add half of that and see what we're working with.
Now, is that a full cup of water like it answers?
No, just one cup.
Want to tilt it so they can see what's up. Yeah.
Right, so just like that. So the consistency is not where we want it to be. Mm-hmm. Right.
So you're looking for like a paste?
Right? Yes, somewhat of a paste. It's too thick. So we're going to add the rest of the water. Let's see what we're working with. Just a little at a time because you don't want...
So what if you ended up adding too much water?
You just add more flour.
Okay. Okay.
Right? You still need more water.
You see
water.
That mix? You see the toya mix? Like, and then go back and then you
realize I was hypnotized because I'm just like looking at how she's doing it.
It's the flick of the wrist.
You see, I'm observing the technique. So.
You see? Check that. Starchy
you
episode.
See, when we go to our next chef, when we come with these moves.
The when you get that?
So first of all, guys, it's called the toya chop.
Alright.
And this is called the toya flick.
So you're just going to add a little bit more water.
So far, guys, this is what the consistency is looking like.
Right.
So she's trying to get it a little bit more pastier. But for now, yeah.
So we're going to add a little bit more water.
Do you add lime to that?
I already added the lime to the conch.
Okay.
Just to cut out, you know, the freshness of it. But you can add it if you want to.
At what point did you add the lime to it? After you beating it?
Yeah.
And then you added
it to
a bag?
I squeezed it after I did the chop. And that was in the bowl. I added just a little bit of lime in it.
Oh, okay.
But if you wanted to, if you were making it and you kind of smelling like
it's
a little fresh, you just take a little bit of lime and you squeeze it in.
Okay.
There's no...
So is this something that you could do overnight? For example, you beat and cut up overnight and add the lime and everything?
You could actually do this entire thing and put it in the fridge.
Okay.
That's true.
And you use it for maybe it will last you maybe 2 days max. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But then the baking powder will start to turn. So you kind of have to use it
the following day, preferably.
Yes.
Okay.
So you're looking for something of that sort of consistency. Just like this.
Now that looks like it's gonna be some loaded acros. Mm-hmm. You see how you've seen so much chunks?
You see, you're making me hungry.
That's why you have to cook at your home.
So you see, so when you add it to the...
Yes, right. It's not too watery. It just, when it drops, it stays.
So you see,
that's
what we're looking for.
And it's not cheese.
It's not cheese.
Yes. Yeah. I have a lot of things.
It's not cheese. It's not...
I love that.
I hate to eat an acro and all you're tasting is flour. That bugs me.
But you never see you go out too and so you can see the batter or the container they're taking out from. And I've seen some really runny batters and... batters that don't look as colorful as this, so yeah man, that's some good stuff right there.
So let's get the oil ready.
Yay.
So we're gonna put our soam on.
More fire.
Blaze of fire.
Lava. What are they saying?
Who said this lava thing?
Let's not even go where it stemmed from, but it is now that one might be controversial.
Long story.
So I'm using Maggie's coconut oil to fry up.
I find coconut oil gives things such a lovely flavor.
Me too. And I love this coconut oil. I use it a lot actually. For fry and for salads, you can use it for anything. So when the pan gets a bit hot, we're gonna add the oil and then I'm gonna have y'all scoop in the conch fritters.
Alright.
The conch acros.
Yay!
So, fried up. And we're gonna paint it nicely.
Okay.
We're gonna paint it.
Nice.
Ooh. So I mean,
I'll let you taste. I'll taste the fried thing. I believe it looks and smells good.
You just want to taste it a little bit to see if it has enough salt, if it has enough flavor.
That is good. You're going to love that.
Okay.
You are going to love that.
Are you looking at life? Can I see
it? Yeah, that don't mean you should take anymore.
I only need to leave some for the man of the house, but y'all could leave with this for me when we're
done. Okay.
That's all. I just have to leave for.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I mean, I don't know who said it was going to get any, but. I'm kidding.
Okay, so you want to add your oil?
What oil are we adding?
Oh, you don't want to add, boy, to give you a measurement there, boy, you know how
this goes. That one, you know, now, you see, now that's something.
Okay, so we started with a full bottle, right?
Not really,
No, we didn't.
Okay, so the bottle was maybe here, so I use this amount.
Yeah, okay. That's half a cup.
Mm-hmm. Half a cup,
like
roughly, you know?
But you all know true Creole cooking, just as Toya did there, is like, to taste,
you just
you never see you as somebody their recipe and they say, well, I know I'm using this, that, and that. I can't tell you the amounts that is just put. Yeah. And that's, you know, that's,
and that's just what it is.
That's just what it is.
So you want the oil to get nice and hot. You don't want to add the batter. Batter in when the oil is warm, because what's going to happen is the batter is going to suck the oil and it's going to be oily. It's not going to be and the inside is not going to be as nice. It's just going to be like an oily mess.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So you just want to go over and feel like this. If you feel like it's hot enough, then you're good to go.
Or are you one of those cooks who, you know, have a plate with a napkin and then they put the fritters in the napkin to soak up the oil?
Yeah. And normally it's better too, because then, you know, like I said, we really like this oily
right. So I'm going to have you all do the honors and come with the batter. And you want to take that spoon we have right here, which is more like a tablespoon. And then we have you all do the honors.
Oh boy. You know what? You're taller, so here you go.
And just scoop out.
That's enough? Oh, that's too generous.
Okay, the lady, I'm going to show you how to scoop out the first one. So you want to take it like this.
Oh, St. Lucia is trying to give you all too much.
Right? And then you basically want to go in.
Okay.
Like so. Just like that, and it's nice and bubbly. You see, the oil is hot enough.
How many fritters do you think we're gonna get?
A lot.
Let's see who will come close.
A lot.
Closer. I think this would maybe be about. So
this is better.
A little bit more. You have to eyeball it. That's good.
You know.
And gently fold it, because it's falling. So you have to be careful not to have any that's falling off of the spoon, right?
Hold on. I feel like that fritters. That will be your.
Okay, that's not bad. Hold on, okay, too many people tell me what to do.
Okay, just do your thing.
Don't fight it in the kitchen. That's rule number one.
Let me show you.
Anyway, let's open this.
Let
me show you. And without disturbance,
I'm fine. Alright, watch that now,
Notice that I'm not disturbing you, So when it's my time to drop mine,
very nice,
don't
Shanro.
Disturb me.
Boy. Very nice, Shanro. And this smells so nice. Y'all smell that? That smells so nice. Let me get a plate so we could put our stuff on.
Alright, there we go. Okay. So, you know, so many people doubting me right now, guys. I'm just gonna do this my way. I bet you it's still gonna be good. I'm doing so. Right there. Perfect. Like that. Bam. Alright? No disturbance. Thank you.
You don't want to crowd the pan too, so maybe two or three.
That's enough.
Until it starts to get brown around the edges. You start seeing it get brown, that means it's cooking. Then you flip it, and then you start over, you put the fresh batch in.
I feel like we're getting maybe, I feel like we might get 10.
Maybe 15 to 20.
Wow.
That's very good. Sorry guys, they still the wind blowing, that smells
so good, I know, right? That's what you want.
Really does smell.
So it starts to come up like it's floating. It's because of the baking powder.
Okay.
Right. It's not gonna get puffy, but it's just gonna. I don't like puffy acras. I don't know. Everybody's different. I like my acras flat.
Okay.
Yeah, that's just my whole vibe. I just like it like that.
Well, this is what we have.
Yeah.
Everybody has their technique. Once it tastes good, that's all I want. But it's already smelling good. The batter tastes good, so I don't think we can go wrong from
we
here.
We can't.
So until we
fry.
So that's medium heat?
Yeah, so that's full heat.
Oh, full heat, okay.
You don't want it to be on medium because it's going to take too long to fry and it's going to be dry.
Okay.
You still want the center to be moist. You know, you still want the center to be moist. Okay, so we need a pair of tongs. It's behind you. So just get a pair of tongs.
Tongs.
Okay, so we're going to take it and we're just going to flip it just like so.
Woo.
Nice and golden brown, mm-hmm. which is what you're looking for.
Smelling good.
Jeez, hurry up, Oman.
It's taking too long.
Yeah, taking long.
Watch her, you know, she does steal a thing. And by the time we come to plate, how much thing does we missing?
Okay, you could probably put another one in there.
Okay. Let me redeem myself now.
Redeem yourself, Michael.
No, you're an audience.
All right.
Right. Very nice.
Now, at least I'm not going to get the boot out of the kitchen.
No, you won't.
Alright, so while we're watching it, I feel like it feels a little, you know, intimidated by us watching.
But you see, you know, just like
just giving it some energy, you know.
So at least we have three that's ready to taste and plate, you know, and we finish and then we'll fry the rest. But at least we have three that look like it's, you know, ready to go.
So the tamarind chutney, how does, like...
Okay, so I'll show you. You could either like just drizzle it over, or you could put it right. So you could put it in a nice dipping bowl, and then you could just dip it and eat it. Okay. Yeah.
Natalia, thank you so much.
You're welcome. You could do that at home.
My son going to be happy to Junior Quayle because he loves afros.
These remind me of what we call at home flitters. Flitters. Yeah, we have like banana flitters. Plantain flitters, saltfish flitters, it's pretty much
the same.
I mean, minus the seasonings, but it's just
the banana one, I don't know if you've ever tried it.
Yes, I've had, I mean, that's
I
like
love
a
it.
Staple.
It's like bananas, right?
Just bananas.
With
the same flour, baking powder,
cinnamon, that sort of thing. It's a sweet treat.
It's really good. You could consider it dessert.
Try some
I will make that. And break for y'all.
Yes. Let's see when we will.
She said that, sir. So,
thank you.
Okay.
I'm
not
ready.
I'm
gonna make that. I'm gonna do that.
Okay. We have this one on camera. By show three, I'm gonna have Jaden put that in the
Okay, so you wanna put another one?
Yes.
Ma'am. How many are we at so far?
So we have four.
Six.
So no stick in it because, that's concert.
No, it's okay.
Alright, there we go.
It's gonna fry, it's gonna bubble and bubble.
Ready? Bubble it up.
Once my hand's not too busy there, I'll start to drum for us again.
Listen.
We'll have a whole section.
This has me like...
The conch?
Yes!
I'm gonna grill it on Sunday.
I still can't believe this is it in its natural state. Because I've just only had it prepared, so seeing it like this is kind of creepy.
Listen, I just want to say that looks so weird.
Yeah,
it feels so, you know.
It feels weird too.
It does. It feels very slimy.
It's a good thing you only showed us that after you already had the chopped one. Because I was like, okay, it looks like this in the bowl, so I'll forget what I just saw here and what I found.
I know, sometimes that's why some of us kind of switch from like chicken to meat when we see how they kill the chicken. And then, you know, seeing this and then knowing what exactly it is that we're eating, kind of scary.
It's a muscle. That's all it is.
It's
a muscle. Kind of
scary.
Yeah. And if you feel it, it's like
it's
very, very hard. It's very tough, especially the ends here. That part you have to beat like your life depends on.
Is it? I wish my.
How long were you beating
tough?
For?
Let me tell you.
How long were you beating for?
Like maybe half an hour.
That's a lot
to get to do that because you want when I cook it, it cooks right
through. You use a bottle, of course.
I use a knife.
Oh, you just use the end of the knife and. The base of the knife rather.
I was letting out some aggression.
Okay, you dare.
Really, you are not going to do that.
Right. Yeah, basically, that's what you have to do. And then it gets nice and tender. But I'm going to grill this on Sunday.
Okay.
Yeah.
We'll be
here. Excuse me? No. I might just come and just check to make sure your lawn was okay because I parked on the grass. Mm-hmm. That's all.
You're going to come and check on the lawn?
Well, because I have to give it a couple of days to see if it's brewing or not, you know?
Okay, got you.
So
when you come in, just pick me up because I think I have fertilizer.
Yeah, because you forget you had to bring the thing. But it would be such a nice flowers and we drop in.
Right.
I won't be home, not that I grilled it up.
Okay.
Oh, but you could still come in and check on the grass.
I'll come and check on the kitchen garden. Okay. I know Shanra says she's going to pick up one too already. So if you see anything missing there, just know it's her. I just drove the car.
Are we looking over there?
We're looking good.
So you mean to tell me we have to wait for all
and
finish?
No, we're gonna do this last batch and then we're going to taste.
I was just asking for a friend, you know, or viewers. I think they want to know.
I know the cameraman, they've been looking really hard. I want him to taste it, right? You're smelling it, you'll be like, Miss, here, how to taste that? Taste it in the time.
Shake your head behind the camera.
Just have a shake like,
I mean that.
Look, all his hand trembling, he's getting hungry now.
This is a good show because then you'll get to taste the food after, right?
It's a great show.
Well, let me tell you, we've learned from last year. We come with an empty stomach. Mm-hmm. An empty hand, so we help out as much as possible, and they feel sorry for us, so they feed us.
Last year, we ate healthy. We had curry goat last year.
But I don't know if you put manicure on the healthy.
That's not healthy.
I don't know what's the general definition of healthy.
I mean, we had breadfruit. We had
because I wouldn't classify manicure in my books as healthy.
We had lobster. We had.
Is how you had it?
We had all of those.
That make it
okay,
healthy.
So leave that and then bring the fries.
Oh, sorry, yes. It was so healthy.
Yeah, it was extremely healthy.
It was very healthy. It was Junicoyo.
Healthy.
That's what, Junicoyo healthy. Because everything was fresh ingredients, you understand? Most people will grow their own stuff too. Now you see? I don't know why I didn't pick up from that and start my home garden from last year. You know
there's a company that gives you a starter garden. They give you a box of soil with three plants.
Yes. Actually, I'm supposed to interview. It's a little boy.
Yes. And he makes the boxes on his own. I think he's like, what, 12?
Yes, I know his mom.
I bought one of the small gardens from him when I started. The basil I have outside is from him. And the basil and I think one of the thyme trees.
Okay.
And he gives you like a nice little starter with salt.
It looks like a nice little wooden toolbox.
It's so nice.
You have to go in the back and check out Toya's garden.
No. Listen, don't let her see where you have that garden. Alright, yes. She's going to raid.
Next thing you see, I love a woman and I come back and I'm going to raid.
Yeah, you're right.
You understand?
I'm like, what?
But not DBS first, because we're not only on the story, we might catch the culprit too.
No. I'm here to protect and serve.
That's news, you know. That's news.
I'm here to protect and serve.
Pretty and larceny. That's what.
Okay, so I feel like this batch is, we'll do these after, but I want y'all to taste.
So I think you're right. That's more than 10 in it.
That's, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10.
And then we still have more.
Yeah, so we're going to fry them later. Just want to make sure we get everything in there. You always want to check it and make sure, you know, you want it golden brown. But everything is holding, baking powder, the water. It's not separating, right? And that's what you want. You want a nice.
Come together.
Yes.
Drain it. No, I rinse that plate. That will come down because my hands will be empty, so I'll provide the rhythm.
Plate it.
Then eat it. Imagine
that guy. Our final two, and then we're going to plate it. Then we have a little dipping bowl. Dipping sauce. I like plating food. I cannot just for me.
My food has to look good.
And I like white bowls, white plates, white serving things, white mugs. I'm a white girl.
I'm quite the opposite because
so, you wouldn't believe how cheap they are. I bought them here, all of these, cheap, everything cheap. Nice. The plates, but I just like white. Yeah. I find white is such a.
It accentuates the meal.
Yeah,
it's
maybe, a nice look. You know.
Nice look.
Listen, when you're at home and you set up for yourself like that, you know, it for me,
it makes you feel good.
It makes me want to eat. Like even simple things, if I'm drinking water or coconut water or even juice or malt, take a wine glass because instantly I just feel good.
It's true.
I'm like, okay, yeah, I'm going to sip my water in a wine glass. I drink more water like that.
It's true.
Let's go. So why not?
Am I the only one who cooks and eats though?
Like whilst you're cooking,
No, I do too.
I don't have no appetite when I'm eating.
When I cook, I just don't want to eat after.
Yeah, me too. So I would eat like maybe an hour or two later.
Yeah.
I won't eat right away.
Okay, well, while I'm cooking, I'm eating, and then when my belly's full and I eat my dinner already.
Excuse me, but what's the point?
I don't know.
That's what I tell you.
I mean, that's a habit. It's a habit. Because you know you always want to taste, and boy, that tastes good, and you go back for second and third.
I don't want you in my kitchen, no? At all. Like.
I think we'll do a separate confession cam so we can just lay it all down.
I think that only happens in my kitchen when I'm around.
No.
Okay.
Listen, that's what I tell you. When we plate in that, watch it, you know, because we might end up with like six plates, and I want to know whether four went two.
So we're ready to plate.
Hey.
So Shanri will do the honors.
I'm sure you want me to do
this. Looks so pretty.
No, well, it's counted, so we know we're supposed to see 10 on the plate.
Hey. Okay. All right.
So you want to put them all along, and then we're going to put the tamarind sauce in the center. Yes. Okay.
So we're going to take one at a time. Don't fall there.
This here smells so good. Guys, I wish you were tasting this right now.
You don't want to go down, my boy. Okay.
This is like a nice appetizer. If you're doing like a home dinner, a dinner with friends, a dinner party, you could have this as like one of the appetizers or starters in your...
Call me plate roll.
I think y'all should do this all the time, not only for Junequeo, but going to the homes of people y'all know through social media, what have you.
Yes.
And
see what's cooking.
Yeah, see what's cooking in the kitchen.
That's right.
Even some guys too.
Yeah, I agree.
Mm-hmm. Jaden, would you be up for that?
Oh, yeah, no coffee in the kitchen, sorry.
Lol.
Jaden, don't worry, I know you can cook, my boy. Don't worry, no. Just remember, I believed in you.
Hot bread.
Once you do hot bread and butter, then you pass. Because if it's just bread and butter, then you fail. Nothing beats a hot bread and butter.
No comment. Absolutely no comment.
But so I lie.
Okay, so how did I do?
Very good. So we're gonna put the tamarind sauce in the middle.
Ooh, look at that.
That's looking like barbecue sauce,
Okay, now we're gonna taste.
Imagine I save her, she's about to taste it. I tell her that looking like it hurt you. Burn your finger and it'll catch you.
I believe her. I believe her.
Wow. I've been good all day.
That's at least I'm saving you from burning your finger.
Okay, you all ready to taste? Oh, you want some plates?
We don't need any plates. Okay. But first of all, you ready?
Oh, the song.
We have to bless it. Hey.
Wait, which one was that?
Bubble. Okay. Ah, this is a good memory game. We are saying bubble first, then fry, then. Okay. So every time we say it, we go maji lakai, right? So bubble
maji,
it up, fry to fry, maji lakai.
Alright,
and then what are we doing? Plate it up,
plate it up, plate it up, plate it up, plate it up.
Okay, alright, you ready? Alright, the theme song come together. In 3, 2, 1, ah! Bubble it up, bubble it up,
bubble it up, bubble it up.
Fry it up, fry, maji lakai. Bubble it up, bubble it up, fry it up, fry, maji lakai, maji lakai. Now plate it up, plate it up.
Okay, so we have to cheers,
That's true. Manners first, let's not get carried away.
Let's pray. Father, bless Toya's hands, destiny, amen.
Amen.
And both make it all to moon.
Cheers!
Okay, taught it. Oh my God!
Toya!
That tamarind sauce tastes like a sweet and sour sauce. Like, I love a sweet and sour. Somebody, okay, for evidence,
okay.
And run that story on DBS that our own team member, teething our phone.
It has a nice little spice.
Black pepper. Put a little pepper in it.
Because I don't like hot, like super hot food, but this is tolerable spice.
Toya.
This is delicious.
Toya.
Oh my God. You know, I even forgot that this has lobby in it.
But you know, I like you tasting the lobby.
We're tasting it.
We're tasting the lobby.
So, okay, St. Lucia, here we have it. Lobby is not that bad after all.
It's hot, so.
And this is, yeah, you see the sweat coming on?
Channel. Yeah, I finished mine already.
Wait a minute.
Okay. I just wait for permission to go for the next one.
Wow! It's hot, how you eating
now,
it?
Now, you'll see the sweat.
This is hot, but it's good.
I'm going to dip one more time.
Toya, you are
Toya, okay. So now that I'm actually, we've spoken about this tamarind sauce from start to end, but I'm actually tasting it now. Just remind me what you did one more time, because you know I'm not exotic, so I didn't really care for the sauce.
Does the sauce have some sort of pepper in it? Because I know I'm tasting a little
spice. So okay, so just give me a quick rundown one more time.
So tamarind, some garlic, some hot sauce, granulated garlic, hot sauce. I use some of these peppers because a few of them are hot. Water, that's basically it. Salt,
so
black pepper.
Did you do the tamarind? Did you boil it? Did you?
No. Well, I put it on a fire with everything, and then I mash it, and then I strain it, and then I put it back on the stove so it could reduce and get thick.
Now let me trouble you some more.
Sugar. I forgot. Sorry.
did you actually like the tamarind off the
After it boils, it comes off, the seeds come off.
Okay.
So you just run it through the strainer.
Okay.
The strains, wow. All the pulp and everything.
I wish we could have caught you when you're doing
that. I know, I'm sorry, but it took long. And to be honest, I wasn't sure how it would come out.
Mm.
So I didn't want to do some camera.
That's why she didn't do it on camera.
I didn't do it on camera, it wasn't good.
But guys, listen, this is amazing.
I'm actually moving on to my third. What is y'all doing?
Excuse me, the guys have to. Guys, I want y'all to taste.
So should I take over the camera to get there first?
Yeah, I want them. I want them to taste it. I want them to taste it.
Oh boy, Jaden, you're making a debut.
Alright.
Come, Jaden, come. I want you to taste it. Dip
Delisha,
it in the sauce.
We want you to meet the guy that either makes us look good or ugly, fat or slim. On TV, so if
he said he makes us look slim with his camera.
He said so if we're looking bigger, just know he messing with us.
Alright,
so Jada, you ready?
In the pudding.
Eat it. Now you can't put that in your mouth if you stand up there like a post. If you're not dancing, you cannot eat.
Hey, Lord.
That's not the spirit of
Junior
Koyo.
Who said dance though?
Who said?
Eat my boy.
Don't make me make
okay.
Them put a special edit there.
You all have evidence of me, okay?
Eat it.
Bubble is a bubble.
Fry it a fry. Plate it a plate.
Plate it a plate.
Cry here, cry.
Thank you.
And he has to taste too. Mm. All right. So Kwame, come in and try next.
Come on, Kwame. Come on. Well,
let's go.
I love him.
Camera catch him saying no. Okay. Well, we one man down.
Good.
This is what it's all about.
I gotta be doing an elbow touch.
Hey. Look at that. Kitchen so close since the time. Now you're doing elbow touch.
Hey, it's a style, eh? What happened to that girl?
Anyways, good people. This is where we're gonna have to sign out for today as we continue to just enjoy these little goodies. Hopefully you try it at home as well.
And I hope so.
Yeah, Matt. Antonio, thank you so much.
No problem.
Like, I already knew you could cook, but this is on another level, and now my son will be happy for the Creole season thanks to you.
No problem.
So I feel like we just need to. Shannon, are you ready?
Mm-hmm. You ready? You ready?
We have to say goodbye, you know. From Toya's kitchen to you all, we are trying to say.
All right, we good.
All right.
What are we trying to say?
We're saying goodbye, but we're singing it out.
Oh, we're singing. Okay.
Well, I just said from Toy Boy. Okay.
From my kitchen. From Toy's kitchen.
From Toy's kitchen.
Majelakai.
Majelakai. This is where we are signing out, guys, and we will see you next time. Make sure you tune in for our Creative Creole Cooking. Majelakai. Official theme song. Ready?
Ready?
Closing out in
5, 6, 7, 8.
Bubble it up, bubble it up, fry it up, fry it. Majelakai. Bubble it up, bubble it up, fry it up, fry it. Majelakai. Majelakai. Majelakai.